So hello students, today we are going to study the most important topic in the rotational mechanics, and that is known as the torque, right? Now why this topic is important, dear students? Because at many places you will find in your real life also the application of the torque itself, right? So when you see the torque, you know, when you observe the torque, actually the mechanical torque, suppose when you use a wrench, right? This kind of wrench, when you use wrench, right, this kind of device, if there your car is punctured, suppose, right, then you have to open the wheel, then you use this kind of device, wrench, right, cross wrench you use, right. So when you use the cross wrench, then what is going to happen? You are applying the force in the either direction, right, opposite directions, right, like this, in the parallel to the axis, right. So this thing is going to do the rotating motion, right, and it will open the nut here, the nut which is fastened, right, to your car tire, you open that, right. So how to understand this torque in terms of the physics? Let us do that. So what is basically the torque? Is the torque is defined as what? That is, the simplest definition is moment of the force, right? That is the simplest definition. Right, when you are saying this word moment, what does it mean? Let us understand this. Right, force you already know, right? Okay, now let us consider what, that there is at the point P, right, there is a particle on which you are applying some force, right? So this is the direction of the force you have. Now from the position vector r of this particular point P, this is r. This r position vector is extended, let's say, like up to a certain place, like this, right? Okay, so the angle between F and R, this is what, this angle will become what? Theta, right? Okay, now when you are saying moment, what does it mean, dear students? Let us take the components of this R with respect to this force, right? So how will you write the, I draw this, if I just extend this vector along this line, let's say, right, then the perpendicular distance will be this from the origin, this will be the perpendicular distance, and this will be the hypotenuse of this triangle. So if I write here, suppose this distance is, let's say it is d, right? So d by r will be what? That is sine of theta, right? If I take this angle is theta here, right? Vertically opposite angles, right? So d will be equal to what? That is r sine times of theta, right? So this moment of force can be written either as what? That is very simple. That is, it is torque is what? Force, it is a product of what? Product of force and perpendicular distance from the line of action. That's a very simple one. Simplest statement, force into the perpendicular distance from the line of action. So the perpendicular distance from the line of action will be what? The line of action, the perpendicular distance will be what? That is r times of sine of theta, right? So I will write the formula, that the symbol is what? That is torque. This is a symbol tau. The Greek alphabet tau, right? This is a symbol of torque tau will be what? That will be r sine theta times of this F, right? The force applied, right? So I can write this as what? This will be r cross of F. Alright, dear students, that will be tau, right? Why I r cross of? Because AB sine theta is what? A vector, B vector sine theta is written as A cross of B, right? Very simple. So similarly, r sine theta times of F will be written as what? That is r cross of F, dear students. Now, there is one important thing here, which is to be understood, a very important thing, right? And what is that? That this torque, if you see in the linear motion, when you see that, observe the torque, right, and then, or in the rotatory motion, when you are observing the torque, can you observe the linear motion? The answer is no, right? In the linear motion, when you want to push anything, right, then you have to apply the force. Similarly, in the rotatory motion, you have to apply torque to rotate the body, right? Okay, so that means what? It is the rotation, torque is what? Torque is the rotational analog of the force. Rotational analog of the, right? Okay, of the force in the rotatory motion. Very simple. Right? So this is all about the torque. Now the very important part is
is the unit of this. So the unit of the torque is what? It is simply joules, right? This is the unit of the torque. Okay, as same as the energy, but it's not energy actually, it is the vector quantity, right? It is the rotation analog of the force, right, in the rotatory motion. That means in the linear motion, you observe the force, right, as the coil, as a particular physical quantity which can give you the push, okay, along the direction which you where you will apply it. Similarly, when you want to rotate any body, you have to apply the torque here to rotate that body at the common axis of rotation. This I have already explained you what is common axis of rotation. Now, dear students, a very important part is what here in this talk, right? Is the dimension. The unit is joules, the dimension is what? Single the unit of the dimension is what? ML2T-2. Very simple. These are the dimensions of the torque. So this is all about the torque, dear students. And then we will also explain in the next lecture, I will explain you what is the linear moment, angular momentum. That is also very, very important, dear students. So thank you so much. So how about dear students, let us understand the angular momentum now in the similar terms. So the same particle is there at the point P, now the velocity direction is what? At this direction, the velocity is there. And this R vector is a position vector and it is being shifted, right? So similarly, right, as we have done the definition of the torque, angular momentum is also defined as what? That is the moment of the linear momentum. Now, when I am going to say this moment, you already know that it is the perpendicular distance from the line of the action, right? So here I can observe what here, that this R, if you see the component here along this direction will be what? That is R sine theta. So the momentum, linear momentum will be what? The linear momentum will be simply what? You already know this. That is the mass into the velocity, right, of the particle, right? Now the angular momentum will be defined as what? The symbol is L, right? L, the symbol is L. It will be defined as what? The moment of the linear momentum, that means what? This will be R sine theta perpendicular distance from the line of the action times of this Fb, right? Okay, or you can write R sine theta, right? Okay, times of what? You can write this as again. And you can take it as common, right? M, you can take it outside, not common, right? So this will be M, right? Okay, then R sine theta times of the V, right? So this will be M times of what? R cos of V, simple, right? Okay, you write the cross products, AB sine theta is A cross V, so it is M times of R cos of V, right? Now, one more thing which is important here, right? You can write this MV as the linear momentum, that the symbol is what? P. So this is R sine theta, right, times of the linear momentum, that is P. So this will be what? This will be R cross of P, dear students, that is the angular momentum. This is also one of the formula that is important, right? Okay, now let us do the unit of this, right? What will be the unit of this? Will be what? That is the R cross of P. The unit of the linear momentum is kilogram meter per second, and it is again meter, so this will be what? This will be kilogram meter square per second. This is the SI unit of the angular momentum, right? And again, one more very important thing here, right? That is the dimensions. So the dimensions will be what? M for the kilogram, then L2, then T minus 1. These are the dimensions of the angular momentum. Very, very important here, students, right? Now, this angular momentum is to be derived in terms of the torque, right? So that also we are going to do, dear students. This is also very, very important to understand how to do this angular momentum in terms of the torque. For that, we have to differentiate this right equation, and that we are going to do in the next lecture, dear students. Thank you so much.